words to the song say, "Listen to my heart, forget me not." And the purpose of this tape is to keep Zaida alive so that future generations of our family will know something of the history, warmth, and caring that made Zaida a very special person to all of us. When you think of Zaida, remember his smiling face, always making light of the heaviest situations. Zaida had a gift that those who were lucky enough to share time with him will surely miss, but a gift that lives on through everyone he touched. Zaida was born on April 13, 1924 in New York City to Morris and Rose Goldstein. Later, the family moved to the small Jewish town of Woodbine, New Jersey, where Stanley and younger sister Anita grew up. The title of this song is Once in a Lifetime, and a person such as Zaida only comes along once in a lifetime. Life in Woodbine passed by pretty routinely until Uncle Sam called. World War II was underway, and Zaida was in the Army now. Even when the Army sent him to Europe, he remained close to the ones he loved by sending home V for victory mail.
He was a famous trumpet man from all Chicago way. He had a boogie style that no one else could play. He was the top man at his craft.
Zaida would not only describe what he was doing, but he would illustrate in pictures how he felt, which was usually thinking about the comforts of the good old USA.
They made him blow a bugle for his Uncle Sam. It really brought him down because he couldn't jam. The captain seemed to understand. Because the next day the cap went out and drafted.
I won't be home for Christmas this year, but I'll be seen at least, if not heard. My presence is greatly demanded right here. Please excuse while I smile at the bird.
To the bar, in boogie rhythm, he can't blow a note unless the bass and guitar is playing with him. He makes the company jump when he plays reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B.
Zaida was seeing the world and in the best shape of his life. Zaida was always a believer in what will be, and if anything good can come from war, it was meeting his future bride and soulmate, the former Bessie Komanovich. You know her as Bubby. Yeah, no more bird watching for Zaida. His bachelor days were gone. He was a one-woman man. To show you just how sentimental Zaida was, this is a picture of the Grand Hotel where they spent their honeymoon. And Zaida saved the receipt from that first night with his bride. It was then back to the States for Zaida and a reunion with his family, who would then welcome his war bride. Yeah, they settled in Woodbine, New Jersey to begin their life together, the dashing couple. Yeah, Zaida would be part of many joint ventures, not the least of which was this, the arrival of Leslie Jean. They began now to live the possible dream of every American.
Dream, the impossible dream.
This is the house in Willingboro where they chose to raise their family.
The unbeatable foe.
Yeah, they added to the family. There was another along the way, a little guy named Mitch. Life in Levittown was good. Matter of fact, Levittown Life was the name of the paper that Zaida started. Yeah, he was the publisher, the editor, the reporter, you name it, Zaida did it. But even with all these titles, Zaida always found time for his family. He always knew what was important. And that was the people around him, and everyone knew how much they meant to him, and he knew how much he meant to them. Zaida, you see, was a man of principle, standing up for what he thought was right, even if it was against the rules. Your Zaida righted a wrong when he fought to change the name of Levittown to Willingboro. The town agreed with Zaida, and on November 7, 1963, the name was officially changed, thus ending the newspaper owning chapter in Zaida's life. On to the Courier Post, where Zaida pioneered the first ever entertainment magazine called TGIF, Thank God It's Friday. As time passed by, Bubby and Zaida settled in a little development named Terrestria. But Zaida would never terrest too long, yearning for his family and the sea.
That one man, scorned and covered with scars, still strove with his last ounce of courage.
The Woodbine Centennial.
I'm here to introduce a friend I haven't seen.
A testament to his undying commitment to causes, a victorious windmill. We will never forget Zaida because he never forgot us. His spirit, his ideals live on.
I always am willing to say something on behalf of my first grandson, J. Matthew Weinberg, whose party is a great party. We're all having a great time.
Zaida adored all of his grandchildren and beamed with pride from each of their accomplishments.
Bubby and I are very, very proud of you. You acquitted yourself well today. And, well, we know that you're a good guy, that you've always been a good guy. And we're looking forward to watching you grow up into the kind of guy we know you're going to be. Bubby?
Mikey, Zaida said, we're very, very proud of you. And we should all stay well and be able to take more trips together. Take good care of yourself and do well in school.
Amen.
I love you. I love you, little boy.
Yeah. A little bit. I do. I love you a little bit, little boy.
Good little boy. Love it.
It was one of those. It was Father's Day. It was like humid, rainy, 99 degrees, 100 degrees humidity.
No, JC. No, Jada's all matter. Aaron comes with his doctor's kid. He's making a house call. Are you making a house call?
Just a bandage.
Oh, here goes the bandages from the house call. He's going to fix me up. Where do I have a boo-boo?
Right here.
Right here? Is this the boo-boo you're going to fix up?
Yeah.
That's a nice one.
Does it taste good?
Let me have this can of
holiday.
time is something we all eventually run out of. Zaida touched us with his undying thirst for life. Always on the go, endless amounts of energy, squeezing all the joy life brings into far too few precious hours. Remember how he lived, for he now lives through all of us. He'll never die as long as we live on. Zaida left this earth at 8:45 on Tuesday, December 28th, 1993. My office clock stopped on that date, I think as one final sign that he wasn't giving up without a fight.
I'll never forget him. And I love being part of his life.